this just came up on my feed. So this is a like a picture of Tony Stark and Pepper Potts in bed, right?
Oh, shit.
I think this was in like Iron Man 2 or something.
Is that the same shirt?
Yeah, but look at this. Pepper Potts is wearing a shirt, yeah. Right? This strange shirt.
Yeah.
And in Homecoming…
Yeah. He has the same shirt. I remember.
For some odd reason, Peter Parker is wearing that shirt.
Yeah. I remember that shirt vividly.
Right?
Yeah.
What's dude doing wearing someone else's, you know, his mentor's wife's shirt though? Isn't that crazy?
Can I just tell you, this is like, again, this is like Marvel's thing about like putting weird ass Easter eggs in like random places.
Yo, but this is not like an Easter egg. He's literally wearing Pepper Potts shirt for some reason.
You see, like, if I speak my true opinion on this, people are going to be really, really upset about me. Upset about that shit.
I'll just say my opinion.
Say it. I'd love to hear it.
I think there's a reason why, like, you know, like, Robert Downey Jr., like, Tony Stark was so hard on him. You know? I'll just say it. Yeah. I mean, like, there's something sketchy here. And now I understand why, like, he got there before Pepper Potts and had to say his piece, like, before Pepper got there. Because this is crazy. You know, they wouldn't do this, like, without knowing.
No, trust me. John Watts definitely does.
They are very detailed. Like that. Yeah. There's a reason why, you know, Peter's wearing that shirt. I think this is insane.
Yeah. There's this other thing that John Watts does in Far From Home, like in the license plates on the cars when the monsters are attacking us, like especially the one we're on the London Bridge or the Tower Bridge.
Yes.
There's a license plate there that like references the comic
the year or the number. Yeah.
Yeah. Where the monster first appeared. And that's like in the license plate.
Oh, dude. Another thing I wanted to ask you then. In Far From Home or Infinity War? At the end of Infinity War.
Yeah.
You do know that you appear, right?
Infinity War. Oh, you mean… Oh, that's the end of Endgame, I think you're talking about.
Was it Endgame when like… No, it was Infinity War. Mm. Oh, it was Endgame.
Yeah.
When Peter comes back to the school and you guys hug.
Yeah.
There's a girl that walks by.
Yes, yes.
She's like wearing the Spider-Gwen colors.
Can I just say…
From Into the Spider-Verse. One of my favorite movies ever.
Can I just say, for the love of God, I feel so bad for that girl because she probably thinks she's so famous now.
But were you aware that… Because this can't be a mistake. She's wearing like a spider web, you know, skirt. Why would you…
See, I'm… Being on the other side of things, I get why fans like to dig deep into that type of shit.
Mm-hmm.
But really, honestly, like… That day, I was crying my fucking eyes out for like 15 straight days.
Because it wasn't intended?
Yeah. because we were working on the scene, you know what I mean? So I paid no attention to that girl until someone pointed it out to me.
Uh-huh.
And really, like, again, I just think that's fans really just digging deep into like some sort of storyline.
But do you think that it was intentional or it was like a mistake? Because for example, if this girl, right, who was just supposed to walk by you guys, decided to show up on set wearing, of all skirts.
Trust me, bro. When I say this… Like, there's so many extras that they deal with that most of the time they wear their own clothes to set. So, like, that…
And
that
she could have been just wearing that?
Yeah, literally. That's probably just her own personal skirt. No cap. Like, I'm serious.
Dude, then she's a genius.
You are listening to the Tableau Podcast.